I can't believe you caught a fish.
I know, and it's a big fish. Check this thing out. Your uncle Jim, your auntie Jim, and your cousin Jim. Come home, Jim, because you need a... It's a Wahoo!
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 Jimmy's still gonna die.
A sunset to our port. It'll get better. And we got Martinique to our starboard.
So we left Grenada. Originally Grenada.
A little bit of beer and packed it all back to the boat and set sail.
No problem, man. Be along with this one, should be nice.
Thank you.
Slim money.
How's it taste?
Good. It's like popcorn more than corn. We love driving here, don't we? There's always something fun happening on the road.
Yeah, they don't have many rules. Wood sticking out the side, logs on the back.
Oh yeah, that was a good one. I forgot about that one.
Umbrellas on trucks.
Everyone drinks a glass of port rum.
Do you have an addiction?
It's like worse than our craft dinner addiction.
This is like,
Jeff has an addiction.
This is incredible. The other thing we did on Grenada was one last hash. Again, that's where you kind of, there's one guy called a hare that runs through the forest and sets a trail by dumping some shredded paper at certain spots, and you have to follow that.
I have this rule, I think Ben thinks I'm crazy, but men shouldn't wear tank tops when they go to customs and immigration. I think collar shirts are better, but...
So we moved through a lot of countries, which means every time we leave and enter, we have to go through customs and immigration. Which means you have to get... According to Ashley, you can't wear a tank top.
Men can't wear a tank top.
So, you bring an extra...
Or a hat.
Or hat. But women... Women are an exception, aren't they?
Yes.
I don't know why women are exceptions to hats.
We have boobs.
It's a big fish. Check this thing out. It's a big Wahoo.
We're gonna pour a little Smirnoff on it, give it a little last drink. It's a Wahoo!
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 Cheers!
Cheers! To dinner!
To dinner!
I think you need a bigger cutting board.
Yeah. Can you get me a bigger cutting board? I guess I'll just have to...
You have to do that in sections.
So I'll fillet this to here, and then we'll do steaks here, yeah? My name is Fish. I donated myself to Ben and Ashley's adventures. Thank you so much for catching me. Go next, the Grenadines.
Carriacou and the Grenadines.
Yeah.
And we did a little stop at Petit Martinique, where we basically just got rained on, gave away a bunch of crap.
Petit Martinique. I don't remember that place.
We gave away our dinghy. Got a lobster.
Oh yeah, we gave away our dinghy. We had a 5-horse outboard, a dinghy, a spare dinghy, deflated, which we inflated and tried to sell as a package to. That's rude, Ashley. We tried to sell our dinghy to cruisers. Other cruisers, and there were no takers. So what we did is we put the 5-horse back in the boat and strapped the dinghy down and sailed to the next island, where we decided to give it away to some local fishermen.
These guys have major lobster.
Where do you guys catch these? Where do you catch them? Out there?
Thank you. You guys build boats here? Sailboats?
Yeah, beautiful.
Sailing boat?
Yeah.
Yeah, we have sailing boats.
Right here?
Yeah.
That's cool. I heard you're famous for your sailboats.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's a sailor here.
Captain. You're a sailor?
Good captain.
Yeah? You own your own boat?
Yeah.
Cool.
So, where are you guys from?
Canada.
Okay.
Yeah. Canada.
I'm Sako.
Sako?
Yeah, not Ninja.
Ninja?
I like it. Boat Ninja.
Oh, do you guys want a dinghy?
Lobster, that's
good. Oh, we got one lobster?
Yeah, one lobster for that.
Yeah,
that's about what it's worth.
It just feels good.
This is actually a really expensive sail. It's a parasail, which is a big spinnaker, but it totally ripped on us. Went to the sailmaker and he said, if you can take sail like this and just rip it, it's rotten. So the whole sail basically is no good. We've ripped it down the leech, the foot, and I think once across, so it would cost a lot to repair. So we're in Petit Martinique, and we're gonna give it away to the sailors here.
We barbecued some lobster and moved on. to Union Bay, which is a hot spot for kiteboarding. Unfortunately for us, it was simply a
monsoon
spot.
Getting pretty serious about water collection, aren't we, Ben?
The wind was like squally and down in between the squalls, and the squalls were just nasty.
That's what a squall looks like.
Free showers! Come on out, free water!
What the winds are you up to? Like 30 knots?
Yeah.
Oh, this is perfect. Perfectly chilled.
The entire city flooded. Everything was flooded. The streets had like 3 inches of water in them, like in the streets, like it was like every street was like flooded with water.
So things are getting crazy now. That guy's hanging onto the pole.
They shut down the schools, they shut down the airport,
other cool thing is when it rains a lot here, you get a lot of outpouring from the land, because they have storm drains, but the storm drains, probably like most cities, go directly into the ocean, but all the mud comes out as well, like all the dirt, so then the harbor all turns into brown.
Scattered into some of the dark.